Hi guys, I'm back with another video, and in this video I'm going to explain the sentence formation or the rules in present simple tense. I hope that you have seen my earlier video in which I explained the present simple tense. So let's start. In present simple tense, in general, in the third person we add s in the third person. So the sentence formation looks like this. First of all, we have subject, then after the subject we have verb, and then we have the rest of the sentence. Okay, so subject, I hope you know what is a subject. So subject means the doer of the action or the doer of the verb. So in this sentence, suppose if I'm saying they speak English at home, so who is the doer? They. So they is the subject, and what is the action here? Speak, or the verb is speak, and then comes the rest of the sentence. So okay, and yeah, here you can see with I, you, we or they, we just put the first form of the verb, and in third person we add s or es at the end of the first form of the verb. So like you can see he, she or it, we have added s, speaks or learns. He speaks English at home. Okay, and then there are also few more rules for adding. Yeah, you can see the spelling for the verb in the third person differs depending on the ending of that verb. So there are also a few more rules. So first example is for verbs that end in O, CH, SH or double S, X or Z, we add ES in the third person. So if the verb ends in O, CH, SH, X or Z, we add ES in the third person. Third person means he, she or it, where the subject is he, she or it. So go becomes goes, catch becomes catches, wash becomes washes, fix becomes fixes. Then second rule is for verbs that end in a consonant plus y, we remove the y and add ies. So I hope you know that there are 21 consonants in English language and 5 vowels. So here we can see that verb is ending in a consonant plus y, r is a consonant and then y. Marry becomes marries, study becomes studies, carry becomes carries and worry becomes worries. Okay, then third rule is for verbs that end in a vowel plus y, we just add s. So the verbs which have y in the end, we just add an s in the end. So play becomes plays, enjoy becomes enjoys, say becomes says, and so on.